Let's move back in history, just 7 years, back to 1969, when one of the most outstanding historical events in modern history took place. Again, moving back in history 78 years, slavery was to be abolished, resulting in a southern state firing upon Fort Sumter in 1861. The Civil War that resulted almost tore our country apart. Moving once again back in history 50 years, to September the 16th, 1811, three Kentuckians, John Hoback, Jacob Reznor, and Edward Robinson, were crossing the Great Valley of the Upper Green River. They were fur trappers. This was a prelude to history. They returned a year later to guide the Wilson, Price, Hunt, and the Astorians. They would establish Astoria at the mouth of the Columbia River. And one who came was a Dorian woman, an Indian wife of Pierre Dorian. Her children were the first of white blood to cross this valley. Many of this party were killed by Indians. The survivors of the party straggled into Astoria in 1812. This pageant is reenacted each year in Pinedale, Wyoming. The pipe of peace is holy. It has been lit and offered to the four winds. Walking away from the stockade is its planner and builder, Captain Benjamin Uyeli de Bonneville and Joe Walker. Captain Bonneville graduated from West Point and got 2 years' leave of absence from the Army, raised some money, and came out west to become a fur trader. Even though he was on leave from the Army, he traveled under orders to explore the country and make a detailed note of all the tribes. The War Department also wanted to know if the British were fooling around in America's backyard. Bonneville was pretty much a greenhorn at this trading business, but he learned fast and got the best furs from the fur trappers. Jim Bridger and his mountain men, William Sublett, Kit Carson, and Black Mose Harris. They came in the Valley of the Green each year just to raise a little hell along with other mountain men and fur trappers. This was the beginning of the Green River Rendezvous. This little cayuse, Kit Carson, didn't weigh much more than 110 pounds soaking wet. The mountain men were a wild bunch and enjoyed roughing it up a little. Or stealing an Indian bride now and then was part of the fun. Woma, chief of the Cheyenne. The chief said, "I want peace for my people and all the good things to go with it. But if someone wants to make war, let him come, and I will turn the Sitkadi red with his blood." Wadzi Wipe, the chief's wife. During councils, one could hear the undercurrent of wisdom from Wadzi Wipe. The antelope men of the Cheyennes. It was their duty to see that the tribe moved in safe and orderly fashion. They were the game wardens in the buffalo hunt. There might have been quiet moments in the Indian camp, but there were very few dull ones. The dancer has a small, neatly carved bone in his hand, and they try to guess which hand has the bone in it. Father De Smet, the man the Indians called the Black Robe, the one who made the Jesus talk. The chief said, "We will listen to this man tell of his God." The creak of wheels. Then the holler came out, "Wagons in!" The real business of the rendezvous was about to begin. A woolen blanket that cost $2 in the East cost $12 at the rendezvous. Needles that wholesaled for 10 cents a gross were going for 60 cents a piece. Whiskey, that had been cut several times, was selling for $10 a pint. It cost 30 cents a gallon in St. Louis. The wagon tracks and pony trails are covered forever by the shifting sands of time. Only Jacob Miller's pictures can remind us of the prelude to history.